Hello, everybody. Hey, so welcome. You guys excited to be here? Yeah? I'm excited you're here. So, all right, turn to someone next to you and say, I'm so glad you're here. Look at someone else and say, I'm so glad you're here. Now look at someone else and go, I'm sorry you were my third choice. Oh, we're so excited. Hey, guys, we're excited to have Ben and Phil Joel here. And aren't you thrilled? Hey, give it up for Phil. We're excited that he's here. He's going to share some stories. He's going to sing some songs that some of you may remember and some of you may know. He's going to sing some that we can all just learn together, and it's going to be a great night. So you guys, one more time, give it up for Phil Joel.
Thanks, Mike. Hello. How was dinner? Yes. Okay. There you are. There you are. All right, what happened to Ben? Oh, there he is. Well, I thought we'd just sing a few songs, play a few, we might start with a blast from the past. This will test some of you. Some of you might know this one. All right, I need you to be a violin. Try this. Whoa, whoa. I won't of you. Okay, that's good.
You're not the only one who cares about what's going on around here. Some idea circulating that it's all going down. So why should we care if we're not gonna be here when it's time to leave this place? Wanna live a better life.
You know what, I really appreciate you two sitting up the front, being brave enough to come and sit up the front. Because everyone else is sitting down the back, and you know why they're sitting down the back, right? They're like, if this is bad, we can leave pretty easy from back here. So, fair enough. I get it. Anyway, well, I'm Phil, and thank you for allowing us to come and make some noise for you. This is Mr. Benjamin Bugner. And... he's from Alabama, but he lives in Nashville, as do I. And we've been playing music for a long time together, and this is fun. And I even wore my snazzy pants for you guys. You know why? Because you deserve it. That's the only reason I came up with. Anyway, yes. So we have been a part of UMC Gathering for a number of years and led worship for them and sung different songs and shared different bits and pieces about our journey with the Lord. And it's been a lot of fun. So thank you for those of you who have entrusted your kids to us for those weekends. Nothing quite like getting together and gathering and looking around the room and sort of understanding, okay, it's not just me, we're in this together. Let's go, let's keep going.
You've been shaking the trees, you've been burning the leaves, you've been breaking our rules, and we're okay with it. We're okay with it. You've been washing our eyes, you've been changing our minds, rewriting the lines, and we're okay with it. We're okay with it. Take us to the deeper water. You take us to the deeper water. You've been climbing walls, you've been making them fall, you've been making tough calls, and we're okay with it. We're okay with it. rise to the deeper water. You dig us through the deeper water. You take us to the deeper water.
Like a number of you, oldies but goodies. Glory, that's it.
He sees you down by the waterline. Knows what you're thinking all the time. He sees the rising of the waves. And when the tide starts rolling in, he lets you know it's gonna be okay. Those clouds should start to break. He'll be standing out in the rain.
glory. Is that a United Methodist thing to yell? I like it. Cool. Okay. Glory. I'm down with it. Yeah. So my story is this. I came here in 1994 from New Zealand to be a member of the Newsboys, and that's what I did. And I got on a big airplane and flew all the way across to Los Angeles and joined the band. And it was a pretty wild ride. And the band sort of started to find its sort of legs around that time. So people seem to assume that I was one of the original guys. But the band had already started, and the bass player had left. And they called me and said, "Hey, will you come and play with us?" And the thing is, I got a phone call at 3 o'clock in the morning from the Newsboys. And at that time, I had sold everything I'd owned, and I'd got a passport. I'd applied for a passport, I'd got it. I'd never been on a big airplane in my life, but I had this inkling that God wanted me to move, and I didn't know what it meant. And and sure enough, this phone call came in and woke me up, and it's these guys, you know, who had no idea about time zones on the other side of the planet, I guess, waking me up and saying, "Hey, can you get on an airplane and fly across the planet and try out for our band?" And of course I said yes, and it happened. But I always look back to that moment, and with my wife, you know, I sometimes we'll find ourselves in moments where we need faith. And I'll go, "Hey, you remember? God can make the phone ring at 3 o'clock in the morning, and he can do whatever he wants, you know?" And it's just the truth, especially as we're getting these inklings, you know, and I guarantee you're all getting these different inklings in your hearts right now at this time of in history. It's a very strange time in history, isn't it? We know this. There's definitely a sorrow that is in all of us that we're feeling. But there's also these other inklings. And I would say to you, whatever those are, follow them. And ask the Lord to keep leading. And they may seem strange. It may lead you to selling everything you have and preparing for something, you know. And that phone call may come. That email may come. I don't know what it is. But God knows what he's doing. And when he whispers those things to you and says, "Come on. Come on. I need to lead you out so that I can lead you in," be obedient to that, because who knows what's on the other side, right? Who knows what work he has, what people group he needs you to reach, who he needs you to love on, and what sort of a repositioning he has in mind for you, because his ways are higher than ours, aren't they? They're just better. His thoughts are just greater, and he has greater perspective. Of course he does. So, anyway, I ended up over here in the U.S., and I met the woman of my dreams in Wichita, Kansas. Woohoo! And Wichita, Kansas girl, and so we were married, and we had a, after about 5 years of marriage, we had our first child. We have two, and had a little girl, and I remember bringing her home, and, bringing her home, and then I remember sitting out on my back porch that night, just kind of, you know, sitting in the fact that all of a sudden, of this realization that I was now a dad, you know, couldn't take this kid back. Life had changed, and forever, this little girl was gonna look at me and call me dad, And it changed me in that moment. I stopped in my tracks. It stopped me. And it made me think about what sort of a man I was and what sort of a man I was becoming. And at this point, I'd already been traveling, you know, this country and the world for 5 years or more with the Newsboys, you know, sharing the good news, singing about Jesus, doing our thing. But I had this moment on my back porch where I realized I knew a lot about him, but I don't know if I really knew him. And like I needed to. And like my daughter needed me to. And I think I'd been doing the whole thing kind of on my own. And so I prayed a prayer that night in my backyard on my back porch. And like any good Nashville songwriter, you take those intimate moments and turn them into songs. Terrible, huh? And but that's what I did. I prayed that prayer, but then I wrote this song to describe what was going on. You can borrow it from me, the prayer, if you want tonight. I still pray this prayer. It's still my prayer. I played the fool so long, thought I was so strong. All the while you knew it wasn't true. Rerunning in my mind, memories of another time when all I ever lived for was you. Jesus, make me the man that you want me to be. Jesus, make me the man that you want me to be. A child is but for so long, turn around, those days are gone. Nothing can restrain the years of youth. I have swallowed lies that tasted truth. The plans I thought were sent from you, when all you wanted was for me to be still. Jesus, make me the man that you want me to be. Jesus, make me the man that you want me to be. Well, I've been listening all my life, words are spoken all the time. I have heard the liars and the truth. Voices twisting in the air, sweetly sounding so unclear, but nothing can replace a word from you. Jesus, make me the man that you want me to be. Jesus, make me the man that you want me to be. All right. Oh, 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 oh. It's rising like a flame, oh, the burning in our hearts is to know you, Jesus, yeah, Jesus, make me the man that you want me to be, Jesus.
The men you want us to be.
So like I said, that was my prayer, and it still is. It's far from over, people. It's far from over. There's a hurting world out there. Actually, really and truly, there's a hurting world in here too. You know, yes, we have the peace that surpasses all understanding, but it doesn't squash and extinguish hurt, does it? And we're all hurting in different ways at this time in history, because it is a weird time. And we're being tested and we're being refined. We're learning and we're growing. And it does seem like for some, that maybe this is a time of death, you know, like, oh, it feels dark. It feels dark. But maybe it feels dark because it's not a funeral you're experiencing, but maybe you've been put in the ground and covered over for a while so that some things can die off, so that that seed can come back up and bear new life and new fruit. Right? That may be where you are. Hey, this is a song about, oh, hey, I've got to point something out. I made a record during COVID, and literally a record, like plastic, you know, vinyl. Yeah, I've always wanted to. Turns out it was a really expensive process, and now I owe money on it. But anyway, if you have a record player and you'd like one, they're over there. And then, of course, we have other plastic products as well. Still believe in plastic, you know, even though I'm a hippie, I shouldn't, but it just sounds better, guys. Okay, here's a song about a member of my my clan and substance abuse. I'm sure you don't deal with substance abuse in Mississippi though, right? So it's probably irrelevant. Hey, you there with the big gun, what you gonna do, where you gonna run when it all hits the fan? And you know it will, cause you don't care, cause you don't really know what it means to care about yourself or anyone else. And I know you got a story that you can't tell anyone. That's what you think. I know some kind of crazy went down a number of years ago, and you hid it down deep inside. Now the garden's on fire, the trees are burning up outside. I wanna run to the tired of inside. Girl, I know you didn't grow up dreaming this is how your life would be. Your heart is like a stone, and you know the only way to get through is push aside your soul. Tell me, do you hear the breathing, the groaning of the earth breathing, waiting for the day it will all be made new again, and all the tears will be washed away. Now the garden's on fire, the trees are burning up outside. I wanna run to the rescue, but I get tied up inside. And now the garden's on fire, still the river's running through. It's now came to be here. Is this where your journey ends, or is this how your life begins? Yeah, so that's a song about a member of my family, and I'd like to say she's kind of all right now, but she's still struggling. But you know, I think as believers, here's a reality: we know that God is really patient with us, huh? Oh, he's so patient and he's so kind. And it's his kindness that leads us to repentance, Scripture tells us. And so our kindness towards those around us who are struggling, And our patience, oh, is so important. It's so important that, you know, we want to see things happen and we want it now, right? We want healing and we want to see healing happen now. And sometimes it does. Sometimes it takes a long time. But God is a healer and he is faithful. Anyway, so we get to be in front of a lot of teenagers a lot of the times, and we get to be invited to youth conferences and stuff. And I love these. I just love this next generation. I really love them. And I know that we can look at them and go, oh, you know, they've got their heads in their phones and they don't know this and they don't know that. And they're just, you know, you can. I get it. I have two teenage kids. And, you know, they are definitely facing challenges, this generation. But they're also holding keys. They're also holding keys. And to the future, and they see things that maybe we don't, because they're still kind of, they're still children, and somehow children have vision and can see and understand things that are just so simple, and they're just right there, you know. And one of those things that is very important to this next generation coming through, and quite frankly it needs to be really important to us as well, is creation care. Looking after this planet. My daughter said this to me. She said, Dad, my generation, we don't care how much you know until we know how much you care. And I didn't think that was I don't think that was unique to her. I don't think she made it up, you know, but it's profound, isn't it? They want to see that we care. We care about the poor, the marginalized, those on the edges, the least of these. They want to know that we care about a planet that is sick in different ways and needs help and needs our attention, because that sick planet affects those on the margins and the poorest of the poor, those farmers who are working subsistence land, you know, in a subsistence kind of way, dependent on equal, you know, consistent weather patterns and these types of things, and they're just not consistent anymore. And so. I don't know, it shouldn't have anything to do with politics. It should just have everything to do with saying, Lord, you put us on this beautiful planet, and you've created us to be good stewards of this thing. And we want to honor our creator by looking after the creation, right? So it's really quite simple. You can clap for that. I think that's okay, because we agree on that. We agree that it's good to clean up after yourself, you know? It's good to recycle. It's good to, we've come up with all these new words these days, you know? My parents just, you know, we just called food that was left on the table leftovers. And we put them in the fridge and we'd eat them again the next day, you know? We wouldn't waste. We wouldn't throw everything out as quick as possible. My mother used to use, you know, she would pack our lunch in old bread bags. Because why buy a bag when there's a bag right there, and rather than throw it in the trash? You know, simple things like that, that we can actually help this next generation with, and they can help us see things too. So anyway, I wrote this song about caring for this planet, and yeah.
Feels like we're yelling at the ocean, yelling at the ocean, trying to keep this tide from coming in. Feels like we're moving in slow motion, moving in slow motion, trying to keep this thing from happening. Send up a flare, let it linger in the sky. Let her know we see the tears she cries. I want to throw my arms around the world. I want to throw my arms around the world. to replace it. I'm letting out birds in the basement. Turn off the light, watch them fly away. I see forest defenders burning Decembers. Open the window, capture the embers. I'm not quite sure what to say.
Okay, all right. Moving right along. Everyone okay? The good thing is I can see the doors, so I can see you if you leave. Yeah, well, Ben, what do you think? You know what? There's a song here that's not on the list, but I think we can play this song. So I came, as I said, from New Zealand and came to this place and I became a citizen. I'm one of y'all. You can cheer for that. I'm one of y'all, y'all. Y'all are y'all. Jeet yet? Yon too? Squeet. See, I'm learning. I'm learning. They didn't get it. Did they understand that? No, maybe not. Glory! So yes, I became one of y'all, and I love this country. Thank you for welcoming me. This country has been very good to me, and I really appreciate you all, honestly, and all of everything that has gone before. This country, you know, it's founded on this experiment, you know, of democracy and of equality is the idea. Liberty and justice and all of this good stuff, an opportunity for all. But you know, the trick is we're not there yet. We are not there yet, and we've still got a ways to go, huh? We've got a ways to go. And I started writing this song when we were out on tour. We were out on tour again with the Newsboys back in 2018 and then 19. We were in this room here actually in 2019. And then 2020 happened. And then there was an occurrence in the midst of 2020 that just turned everything on its head beyond the COVID. a tragedy in Minneapolis that caused us all to stop for a moment and realize we're all connected. We're all connected, and we felt all of us felt one another's pain for a moment, felt struggle, felt the struggle of inequality and the struggles that others face, and there was a beautiful moment there. And then the pundits and the politicians came and stole it from us and divided the world again, and it was ugly. But I'd already written the song, and I was in the process of recording it, and it's on that record. So if you've
come on, let love lead us home tonight. We're all right. Don't you know that love makes us one and the same? We've been waiting for the day we can see each other. Truly as we are, every race, every creed, every color in this beautiful world. We're all right. Now come on, let love lead us home tonight. We're all right. Don't you know that love the stars, under the stripes, beneath the north and southern skies. Yeah, we've been dreaming. We gotta keep the dream alive. Every daughter, every son, let them know how far we come. We gotta keep our eyes open, keep our hearts hoping, 'cause we're alright. Come on.
Give me a glory on that one. Glory. Yeah. 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 Jeremy.
Jeremiah 17, 7 and 8 says this: blessed is the man who hopes in the Lord, whose trust is in him, because he'll be like a tree planted by the river with his roots running deep. And when the heat comes, when the heat comes, he will not be afraid. And in the year of drought, he will not be anxious, but rather his leaves will get greener and he'll bear much fruit. He'll bear much fruit. I love that. What is fruit? What is the fruit of God in a man or a woman's life? It's love and joy, peace, patience, gentleness, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, self-control, right? Oh, that's the good stuff. That's the yummy stuff right there. And let me ask you a question. Why does a tree bear fruit? It doesn't eat the fruit, does it? The fruit is there for others to partake of and enjoy and become healthier from, right? Because there are people out there that need you to be loving, need you to be kind, need you to be joyful. They need peace. They need to be around some people who are experiencing and living and walking in peace, the peace that surpasses all understanding in a time when the waters are troubled. They need you to be patient. They need you to be gentle. I watch TV, you know. I'm not that much of an internet guy. I get the news. I flip around to the different channels, you know, find out what people are saying. And all I know is this, that we as people who are trying to follow Jesus, we as Jesus people, we need to be about those on the margins, those on the edges, those who feel left out, those who aren't included, those who don't feel welcome, those who are in need. And in order to be those sorts of people, we need to be people like this, who have open hands, you know? Not these types of hands. Ready to give whatever it is that is needed, a hug, a word, money, food, whatever self-sacrificial act it is that we're being called to do, because that's the love that Jesus taught us, self-sacrificial love, so that others may benefit, so that others may feel welcomed and brought in. And it doesn't happen with these. It doesn't happen with these. It happens with these. Yeah? That's what we're called to be, and Jesus will take care of the rest, honestly. Don't worry about your bank account. You do what you can, and you follow him, and he'll take care of you. Because he's a good dad that knows what he's doing. He knows how to take care of his children, right? He's been doing it for a long time. And he just says, see, all he's saying to you is, hey, you trust me. You trust me. You listen to me. You do what I'm telling you to do. You just trust me. You walk this thing out. You watch. You'll grow in fruit. The fruit will manifest and people will benefit around you. And I'll take care of you. I'll take care of you. You can get greener in the midst of the madness. And I wrote this song when things were really dry. Done things right, we're in the middle.
such crazy times. The seasons change, but it still feels dry in the middle. We're in the middle of this. Every test that we go through, our roots grow stronger and deeper into you. And though the rain, it may not fall, our leaves turn greener than they ever were before. 'Cause you are good.
Of everything, the mountaintops and the valleys, the dry times, the times of refreshment, whatever it may be, we thank you, we praise you, we trust you, we trust you. We're not going to run off to try and find refreshment from other places that just make us sicker. When you are the well, you're the place of refreshment we need to be. We trust you, we love you. Make us greener, make us fresher, help us to bear fruit for those around us. 'Cause every test we go through, our roots grow stronger and deeper into you. And though the rain, it may not fall, our leaves turn. Thank you guys. You guys have been really, really cool. And we got time for one more. So maybe we can you, come on, stand up, you guys. You've been sitting down for way too long.
It's the song of the redeemed, rising from the African plain. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. The song of Asian believers, filled with God's holy fire. Every tribe, every tongue, every nation.
ground. Folk songs sung from the dawn of creation. Some were meant to persist. Of all the bells rung from a thousand steeples, none rings truer than this.
That awesome. You guys give it up. Yeah. And Ben, hey, I have a question for you before you take off your guitar. Would you like to make someone's dream come true tonight, Phil?
Of course.
Me and Phil haven't talked about this. So there's a guy in the crowd that grew up wanting to be a newsboy. You would never believe this. He dreamed about it, everything. He became a preacher instead. Would y'all like to see that person become a newsboy tonight? I think Larry Hilliard needs to come up here and join the band tonight. Can we do that chorus one more time and let Larry sing it with you? Tonight. Hey, thank y'all for coming out. Phil is going to be, he's got his booth over here, and you can see it where he's got some stuff over there, and Phil and Ben are going to go over there. You guys want to meet him, sign some autographs, or take some pictures, we'll do it. Something you need to know about Ben, you guys don't know this, his dad is a UMC pastor. Can you believe that? Yeah. from the Alabama conference. So yeah, so he this is like family reunion for him. He knows what he's doing. So over there is the Phil booth. Hey, we thank y'all for coming out. If you are part of the youth groups or groups that wanted to stay and do some silent disco, if you'll come up here to the front, we're going to do that in a little bit and do that. Other than that, let me pray. We love you. Father, we thank you for tonight. Thank you for just an awesome time of celebrating and just come together as the body. Thank you for this conference, and be with us tomorrow as we continue to walk with you. In your name we pray. Amen.